the logician George Boolos called this the hardest logic puzzle ever. There are three gods, true, false, and random, in some order. True tells the truth, false always lies, and random will answer completely randomly. Your task is to discover their identities by asking a total of three yes or no questions. Each question is asked to only one god. The gods understand English, but they answer in their own language, da or ya, but you don't know which means yes and which means no. This video is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one solution to build your website and succeed online. Here are a few clarifications given by Boolos. You can ask the same god more than one question if you want. Your second and third questions, and to whom you ask them, can depend on the answers to the previous questions. Lastly, random flips a fair coin in his mind before answering each question. If heads, he will say ya, and if tails, he will say da. So random always answers da or ya to a yes or no question, just like the others. This is a pretty tough puzzle, so let's outline two hints, and you can pause now or after some of the hints if you want to think about it. For the first hint, let's break the puzzle up into smaller parts, which are easier to manage. Probably the toughest part of this puzzle is that we don't know who is random, making the answers we obtain very difficult to interpret. So the first step is to ask one question to identify for certain one god who is not random. Then after we've identified someone who is not random, we have two questions left to figure out who everyone is. You can pause here if you want before the last hint. For the second hint, let's consider this question that you ask to A, the god on the left. If I asked you, is 2 + 2 = 4, would you respond, ya? This type of sentence is called a counterfactual. We're asking what would be true if we had asked a certain question, Q. In this case, is 2 + 2 = 4? This type of question is very helpful for solving this puzzle. Just like these hints will allow us to solve this complex puzzle, when building a website, having the right tool is key. I can tell you firsthand about the many technical challenges in building and maintaining a website. But with Squarespace, you don't have to worry about any of that. Squarespace combined their decades of design experience with powerful new AI tools to create their design intelligence, so anyone can build an engaging, responsive, custom website fast. Do you want to book clients for consulting or tutoring? Squarespace's Acuity scheduling makes it easy. You can accept payments, manage appointments, and send automated reminders all in one place. With Squarespace's email campaigns, you can easily stay connected with your audience to promote your services and share updates. Squarespace handles the technical details so you can focus on your content and reaching your clients. Head to squarespace.com today to get your free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/drshawn to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. All right, let's solve the puzzle. Let's start by imagining that A is true and ya means yes. So when we ask A, if I asked you, is 2 + 2 = 4, would you say ya? A will truthfully answer ya for yes. Next, let's check what happens if ya means no. Then our question is, if I asked you, is 2 + 2 = 4, would you respond no? And A will respond no, which is ya. So it actually doesn't matter if ya or da means yes. Either way, A will respond with ya, since 2 + 2 does = 4. A's response will always match the word that we used, which was ya. Now, what if A is false, so A will lie? If ya means yes, then A's answer to the question, is 2 + 2 = 4, would be no, which is da. So the truthful answer to the counterfactual question is da, for no. But since A will lie, A's answer is ya for yes. Lastly, what if ya means no? A's actual answer to is 2 + 2 = 4 would be ya for no. So the truthful answer to our counterfactual is da for yes. But A always lies and will say ya for no. So again, A will always respond ya since 2 + 2 does = 4. Now, it doesn't really matter that we ask the 2 + 2 = 4 part. What mattered was that it was a question where the truthful answer is yes, 2 + 2 does = 4. So what if we change the question to be incorrect, like is 2 plus 2 equal to 5? In this case, the answer will always be da. Let's verify this by finishing this truth table for the cases where Q is false. This will confirm that true and false gods will always answer ya or da depending on if Q is true or false, no matter what ya and da actually mean. In the first column, we check if A is true or false, and in the second column, we check if ya means yes or no. Then we have a column for how A would answer the question Q, and another column to decide if that answer is the same as ya. Lastly, we can check how A will answer the counterfactual question and whether or not that answer is the same as ya. These are the four cases that we already solved, and now we can add four more cases for when the truthful answer to the question Q is no. If we ask either true or false a counterfactual question like this, we'll get an answer of ya if Q is a true statement and da if Q is a false statement. This is a way for us to gain information despite not knowing if A is true or false, or even if ya means yes or no. Now, let's use this counterfactual form to solve the puzzle. First, we want to find one god who is definitely not random. After we find one, then we can ask counterfactual questions to see if any question Q is true or false. Let's say we ask A the first question. The key is that A might be random, so we won't be able to gain perfect information in our first question. So let's try to figure out whether B or C is not random. Based on A's answer, we'll pick either B or C to ask the remaining questions. This is a key step because if A happened to be random, then either choice is fine. B and C are both not random in this case. Now we need to make sure that our choice works if A is either true or false. Let's ask A this question. If I asked you, is B random, would you say ya? If A is either true or false, then we know that an answer of ya means that B is random, and an answer of da means that B is not random, so C must be random. So if the answer is ya, we'll know C is definitely not random, and if the answer is da, then we'll know that B is definitely not random. Now we know one god, let's say it was B, who is definitely either true or false. Now let's ask B the last two questions. There are many ways to do this, but we could start with, if I asked you, are you true, would you say ya? If B answers ya, this confirms that B is true, and an answer of da means that B is false. Now we just have to identify which of A and C is random, and we still have one more question to ask. So we can ask B, if I asked you, is A random, would you say ya? An answer of ya means that A is random, and an answer of da means that A is not random. And now by the process of elimination, we know the identities of A, B, and C. This puzzle blows my mind. One of the three answers completely randomly, and we don't even know whether ya means yes or no in their language. It's like we're trying to learn from data that might be randomly corrupted while also being in a language that we don't understand. But we're able to adapt to the situation using the structure that we do know to help us cut through the random noise and draw conclusions. And there are many other ways to solve this puzzle, so please let us know in the comments what you come up with, and subscribe for more videos like this one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.